that's when we set out to start Incognito on the new platform, PlayStation 2, with Twisted Metal Black.
Black was tough because we knew we were getting the series back, me and the guys in Utah, and we knew we weren't relevant anymore. We knew that the industry had moved on. We knew that sort of what was edgy and cool in 1994, 5, and 6 was no longer edgy and cool in 2001. And so what I was in love with on Twisted Metal Black was the world and the tone and the characters and the stories.
Sony would let Dave do really kind of risque things. They were graphic, they were bloody, they were gory. And they weren't just made for, you know, little tiny kids that were probably never intended to play Twisted Metal, especially by Twisted Metal Black.
You know, at the time, a lot of people were looking for really arcadey, bright, happy-looking games. And to make this shift to a really dark game was really sort of a gamble in a way. We knew that we were going for a totally different style. It was going to be a more mature game. We wanted it to be dark and kind of foreboding.
For the first time, we were important. We were feared.
And feel like a dangerous world.
A lot of times you think that when someone has these kind of ideas, you're thinking, are they trying too hard to be edgy and cool and not nerd-like, or do they really kind of think this way? And it really became obvious that in the case of David Jaffe, there really is some deep, dark, evil motivations that kind of, I think, spark his imagination.
There were things I wanted to do in Black that they wouldn't let me do. And some of it was just so... Okay, some of it was valid, right? We had a scene with the preacher who thought he was performing an exorcism, but he was crazy. He was really being asked to perform a baptism. And so he drowns this Well, we had this great shot of, and I have kids, right? I love kids. I'm a nice, gentle guy, but it's a fantasy, right? And in the scene, there was this great shot of him pushing this little, you know, five-day-old into the baptismal, into the water, and his little arms and chubby little legs are kicking around in there, and he's just like shoving the thing down there, because in his mind, he's like exercising this demon. Sony made us cut that. Now, I understand that. That makes sense. As much as I would have liked to have seen that, I understand that. But then you know what it was? It gave people within the company an opportunity to kind of play the, aren't I noble and pious, and aren't I normal card? And it's like, you.
The voice inside me was a figment of my imagination. My God, it was all in my mind.
It was just an opportunity for people to act like, you know, I want to say something and I want to make a statement. It's like, please get the out of my kitchen. I'm trying to cook this stew.
A man cannot hide from himself. There is only one path before me.
A big part of making a game is just getting a visual image of what this thing's going to look like. We had a machine now that we could really do some nice graphics on, you know, take it to a different level. And this one was the first time I felt like we were really creating a universe, a place that was apart from the world that when you go into it, you feel like you're really in a consistent, interesting world. I still really like the suburbs in Twisted Metal Black. That was the level where we had these concepts and we had rendered it on a PC, and to see that turn into a level you can actually play and keep the art style and the personality. It holds a special place in my heart. I still really like that level just because of those things.
I definitely don't think it's the best game in the series. I think 2 is still the best game in the series. I think honestly at that time, I had gotten bored of the mechanics of the series. And so what I was in love with on Twisted Metal Black was the world. And I think because of that, the gameplay actually suffered. It was too hard. It wasn't creative enough. We really tied ourselves up being forced to every level having the same color palette of browns and blacks and grays and clouds in the sky rolling by. And I think the core experience, the interactive experience of that game really, really suffered because of it. And the good news is, just from a career standpoint, we had enough of the other stuff. We pulled off the atmosphere so well And some of the sort of surface stuff so well that we kind of got a free pass on the fact that the gameplay was good, but it wasn't great. But I definitely think it's probably the least quality gameplay. I think 2 is the best, 1 is the second best, and Black is the third best.